I'm just gonna get the tripod. This is ridiculous. I'm just gonna go get it. Get some mate too. I'll be right back, okay? I'm back. It's going to be a bumpy ride. Take it away. Because Harry Potter. Hey, what's going on? What is up? Okay, so what I'm gonna do today, I'm not an expert at. Like, just putting that out there right away. Not an expert. But I am arguably qualified, maybe, to do it. Probably isn't the best way to do it, but this is the way I'm doing it, and I don't know if it's gonna work, but if it does work, you could do it that way too, and it might also work. What am I doing? You see this? Old school. Original iPod mini. I colored it with Sharpie, obviously. It was green. See? That comes up. Just give it a second. Excuse you. What if it turned on now? Oh my god, no it doesn't. See? It's got the sad iPod face. And it makes like... It makes this weird whirring noise. Like it's a really weak hard drive starting to start up, but then it like jumps. It's kind of like... So I thought, you know what? I'll try and change the hard drive on it. Fun fact, this is like the last model of iPod where before Apple made it like really hard to soup it up or whatever. So they're like pretty easy to pop open and disassemble, replace parts. If it works, if this works, I may get a new battery too. Cause they're only like $5 on the interwebs. So, oh yeah, so I got a... There's a sticker on it. Aw, I can't even... So, I got this, a compact flash thing. And apparently, I can change this out with the one that is already in it. So I got a 32 gigabyte. It's supposed to be like, I'm not an expert, but compact flash is supposed to be like, faster and like, more resilient, like, If I threw this up against the wall, and I threw this up against the wall, like, this one's more likely to be okay. Although I have actually thrown this against a wall. Last time it stopped working, I just threw it, and it started working again. I've actually done that a couple times. I don't know if this is gonna work then. That's my idea of fixing. I'm really amped up today. It's probably this mate giving me so much power. To my understanding, you want to be doing this on like a surface that will not conduct any sort of electricity, like a rubber mat. There's a rubber mat somewhere in this house, but I do not know where it is. So we're gonna have to deal with that. Hoping this works. If it doesn't, I'm gonna cry, and I need you to be ready for that. Here it is. Drive thing. Here's this. Okay, let's pop this bad boy open. Let's do it. To do that, you want to take off this top plastic part and this bottom plastic part. I've seen people use like a guitar pick to get in there, just sort of pry it open. I saw in a different place, you take just a tiny drop of hot glue and a popsicle stick and like put it somewhere, like put a drop right there and just pop it off, and then the hot glue will just kind of snap off of the plastic. But I don't know if you can see that. I already jacked this up, so there's really no point in me taking all those precautions. So I'm just gonna sort of pry this off. Be careful. Be careful around the hold switch. Just be careful. I am not responsible if you break your iPod even more. Now I need a tiny Phillips screwdriver. Take the top here, there are two screws, one there and one there. So you want to take those out. You probably want like a container or something to put this in, so you don't lose them. I'm going to use this tin. It has my name on it, and it says Colorado. So you got those screws out. So this thing at the bottom here, you have to like pop these little wings. You have to like pop those over. They're like caught in a little lip. There's four of them. You need to pop them out. Alright, so I got that little metal plate off, and it looks like that now. There's this little ribbon here. You want to pop that out. Gently unplug that with like a screwdriver or something. See, it just unplugs there. Now you just kind of slide it out the top. Check it out. Look it! Well, then you look on the back, and you see you have the battery here, which plugs in right there. Then you have this is the hard drive, which we're replacing. And that plugs in with this little ribbon right there. So you can just kind of pop the battery off. There'll be like little foamy things on it. One little foamy thing, probably. So you can unplug the battery. You can kind of just find this little edge and just pop out the battery. Really in there. Okay, got the battery off. I'm so nervous. So you want to get like this little black tape off of here. To sort of free up the drive. Can you still see what's going on? Okay, so I got all this stuff off. I would say you should save the little bumper things because I'm pretty sure this drive is not quite as thick. This new one is not quite as thick. So you want a little bit of cushion in there to keep it from like rattling around and stuff. So now we have the batteries out, the drive is like loose, we have the little bumpers and tape off of it. So now you want to take something and just gently, very gently, pry these plugs right there. See? You want to pry those little pins out of the drive. So carefully. Oh my god, I'm nervous. Okay, got it out. Now take the new one. I believe you want this part on top. If you're using this brand, put this label on top. Pretty sure. So just gently, very, very gently, just plug it back in, or plug it in. Okay, so plug the battery back in, the batra. Right, battery's in, that's in. Get your computer. I'm told that at this point, you want to not worry about putting it back in the case yet, and just see if it turns on. But I don't really know how to proceed without putting it back in the case, so I'm gonna put it back in the case. Don't force it. If it doesn't want to go back in initially, do not force it. You are not doing yourself any favors. There we go. When it gets to the click wheel at the bottom, it might give you a little bit more trouble. Ooh, nice! For some reason, it turned on, which is good. See, look, watch that thing. Plug it into your computer, see what happens. This is like the best quality video ever. Got iTunes open, plug it in. Having some issues. It's like not a huge deal, but like it's not ideal either. Okay, so hit restore iPod. Restore, blah, blah, agree to everything, boring. Oh my god, I'm so nervous. Is this gonna work? That seems good. Yes, wonderful. That screen that came up for a split second, I like that screen. seems like, all right, it says welcome to your new iPod again. So we get started. Yeah, yeah, whatever. Sync music, whatever. Do something else. Change on there, man. Just put a little bit of music on there for a second. Can you see the reflection of the camera? Okay, awesome. All right, English. I got some trails. Let me plug it in. There we go. Oh, I can't actually upload this video if I leave that in there. So now that it's working and stuff, I'm going to... I didn't put the bumpers on because I just wanted to see if it was working before I bothered, basically. But it seems to be working. So that's awesome. That's more than I had even expected. That's all I really wanted. So I'm gonna turn it off. I'm gonna turn it off again. Undo the wheel plug thing there. And pop it out. Sort of secure the hard drive because it's like... You hear that? It rattles a little bit. Probably don't shake it though, Kim. You just fixed it. Yeah, but dude, it works again. I just went back in and put... I couldn't get all the bumpers on. I just got the long, like, bar bumper on because it was stuff just didn't want to fit in there with both of them. But it doesn't rattle around anymore, so that's really all I was after. Don't force it. Don't you force it. All right, so let's pop this stuff back on. I'm gonna put this piece back on first, this finger. Sort of, you know, be careful, but you want to get it back into the little lip thing is on. That thing just pops back in. And then stick this guy back in. I just kind of stick it back on there. It'll stick. So at the top, then put those two tiny screws back in. Careful that they don't drop in there. That is my biggest fear with this part. And oh god, it almost happened. There you go. Back on. Pop the top back on. Make sure you have this hold switch and this hold switch in the right position, like the same position as each other. Get a nice close-up of how badly I chewed that shit up. Good to go! Bring you back up here. Hey! How's it going? Did you miss my face? I missed your face. Yeah, that's it. Sorry for the super messy location. I didn't bother to clean it right now because I don't really spend much time in here and I don't really care at the moment. So put that in your pipe and smoke it. There's spiders all around you, you know that, right? So you don't even care. That's what I like about you. That's what I like about you, kid. She don't even care. Luna don't care about nothing. That's my cat I'm talking to. Luna. Do you want to see my cat? Meow. 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 What you doing? Come here. Come here. Yeah, come on up. There's that girl. She's a good girl.
She loves me.